Hello, hello. I am Darkness and welcome to Horizon Zero Dawn. If this is your first time with me, thank you so much for stopping by the channel. This is a charity channel. 50% of everything it makes goes to charities in need with an emphasis on medical conditions. But hopefully you'll have a fun time playing Horizon Zero Dawn with me. I'm not going to go into in-depth with all the side quests this game can do. But I'm going to get into it immediately. I just picked it up. And although it says continue, I have not started it. I thought I was going to hit new game to show you guys the intro cutscene that played as soon as I turned the game on. And that's not how it worked. There's another cutscene that's ready to go as soon as you start. So searching in the extras does that intro movie. So let me play that for you guys first. And then we'll get to the actual game and get into the gameplay. So, here we go. Intro movie. Let's do this.
What's that now? Don't like the cold? Can't stay in today. We have a ritual to perform, you and I. Here. Wear this. It belonged to my daughter. Good. Today, I speak your name, girl. But will the goddess speak it back? Normally, it would be the mother who declares, if you had one. The whole village would attend, and matriarchs perform the ritual. But we are outcasts. Even so, we keep the tribe's rituals. Otherwise, we might become like the faithless old ones who turned their backs on the goddess. But their wickedness doomed them. To us, were left the splendors of creation, beasts of air, water, earth, and steel. It is one thing to hunt a beast, another to hunt a machine. You must be humble and respect their power. I will teach you this one day. High Matriarch Teersa, what is she doing here? Does she mean to forbid the ritual?
No, 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 off your knees. It's nearly time. And yes, you may speak to me.
You came to bless the naming.
Have not 6 months gone by since we entrusted her to you?
But we are outcasts.
You by choice. And she, well... I am a High Matriarch, Rost. I bless whom I choose.
Then you honor us.
Yes, yes. Now go and be ready to declare. Go! Oh, Mother, this child needs a name by which to know her. That your love may warm her life as the rising sun warms all the earth. Speak her name! and so her name is blessed.
Stop this at once! What have you done?
I've blessed the naming of a child.
Stubborn woman, you call that curse a child? What did she tell you about his birth, outcast? Answer!
I've done only what you asked.
To raise it, yes. We said nothing of love.
Enough.
And you, blessing its name like it was one of the...
I know my duty to them. And to you.
Without consultation.
I'm here. And wherever you go, I will follow.
So most of the time, when there's a cutscene that's an opening cutscene, I kind of like write it off a little bit. I don't mean to write it off as in it means nothing. It's usually that it's almost like the attention grabber. It's what a lot of the footage that you're getting from commercials comes from. It's what a lot of kind of what the promotional, what you're taking a lot of set pieces from. And it's almost kind of that you rented it or something like that. They're trying to sell you on like making you go buy it now. That's kind of what I see like opening cutscenes as, that kind of do that before you even start the game. This is a big exception. And I didn't expect anything but exceptions from a company that was supposed to be making games to topple Halo one day. Who knows when, the Halo killing franchise known as Killzone. You know that franchise that totally bankrupted Microsoft as they could not make a character really stand out against their franchise. You know, I'm getting an update. Microsoft seemed to have survived the Killzone apocalypse and has subsequently released so many things afterward that most of them trump the whole Killzone series. One. So anyway, this is kind of like a surprise for everyone when they announced this was going to happen. I think in 2015, everyone's kind of expecting an even more bleak and dark announcement, and Horizon Zero Dawn came out. So let's get into it. I'm actually excited about it because it's supposed to be like the first time I'm ever gonna regret. To you guys, it won't look any different. Really, it won't. To me, it's supposed to be the first time I'm gonna regret not playing this on a PS4 Pro. But YouTube compression means that to you guys, it makes like zero difference. So, all right, let's start it. Earth, the far future. Nature has reclaimed the ruins of our forgotten civilization, but humanity lives on in primitive tribes. In this new wilderness, they fight for survival against the machines. Fearsome mechanical creatures of unknown origin. All right, well, that's pretty much what I already knew from the commercials. Aloy, that's how you pronounce her name. I'm glad I saw that in the beginning so I didn't say Aloy. I will say Aloy sooner or later. Do not correct me. I'm just going to delete all comments that have Aloy in it. If I see Aloy in the comment, I'm just going to have a filter that just says, get rid of that shit. I hate you. I'm going to say Aloy. I don't mean it. I know it's going to be Aloy. Whatever. I heard it. It's fine. But let's get into it. Thank you again for joining. Let's get into this. As soon as it loads. One more time, I wish I had a PS4 Pro.
Aloy! Aloy!
By the way, anyone get a Lion King reference out of that opening cutscene? Like, circle of life! Like Rafiki even doing the thing and then baby up to the sun.
Ooh. You're quite the gatherer, aren't you, little Rost? Now go and see if you can find some more.
sorry. I finished it and said bastard in my head. You're quite the little gatherer, aren't you, little bastard? Sorry. Just me.
Well done. That's a good boy. Children, come with me. She's an outcast to be shunned. There. Oh, come on. There.
Is this Batman? Swarmed by bats, and then she makes her bat cave.
Rost! Down here! Rost! Rost! He won't hear me. Some kind of cave?
Oh, new main quest. A gift from the past. Ooh. Go into the cave. Got it. Nailed it. I went into the cave. I did that before I got control.
Oh, there were rats down here.
So, from what I kind of gathered, and this is my own speculation, this is pretty much a Killzone couldn't catch up to Halo. They wanted to go a new direction. The team went apeshit over The Last of Us, and they're like, let's go post-apocalyptic and see what happens. Now, I'm gonna get used to the controls real quick for just a second, but... Oh my god, it is bats. I have a bat cave. I'm sorry.
It looks tight, but I can get through.
Okay. Well, I press circle and dive through it. I don't need you square.
This must be a ruin of the metal world. One of the old places.
Yeah, and so, like, if I understand correctly, all the lore of what made the old world disintegrate is kind of like what Aloy will discover as she's traveling. What made humanity come to the brink. And then this is kind of a story of, you know, you're seeing...
Rost said to never go in places like this. I have to find a way out.
How are... IKEA made things sturdy, I guess. Because this is supposed to be like over 1,000 years later. Maybe even more than 2,000. I don't know. A lot of years later. A story of why she's an outcast. And whoa, hi there. You're not alive. A story of why she is kind of ostracized from her community she was ostracized as a child, so she never had a chance. I'm sure that would leave any child with a lot of questions, and hopefully she'll live, because curiosity usually kills the cat, but usually the protagonist is somehow unkillable, so I'm gonna go with that. I'm gonna go over this way too because.
Can't climb out.
Oh, more bats. Is there not a way to get over to the other place I saw? Okay, there's a ledge. There's a way to drop back down here, it looks like, after you get over there. Alright, I'll. It's supposed to also be an open world, and yes, there's supposed to be many, 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 many side quests that you can do. After I get through the main story, there's a very good chance I will continue playing this game and post side quests, especially those that seem to be more difficult. See if I can surmount them and get them up on YouTube. But for right now, I'm really interested in the story it's got to offer. Side quests usually are like errand boy tasks. Jesus, with the bats!
There's something up ahead.
Is this a medical research facility that I'm in? Everything seems to have that vibe about it.
What's that? A dead person.
That is most definitely a dead person. Nailed it. I don't know if there are going to be collectibles in this game. I don't have...
There's something shiny there.
I don't have a walkthrough. Inspect the strange device. It's a skull, not a device. That would freak you out if technology is pretty much dead and a cell phone came alive in your ear. Oh, that's gonna be trippy. Oh, this is gonna be awesome. So she's got a one up on machines because she can actually interact with the old dead technology that isn't so dead. This is at least a little beyond our time. That looks like an MRI, but we don't have holograms instead of monitors.
A metal door. Close.
We're still.
Maybe this device I found can help.
I would like it to. Use the device to scan the room.
How do I get it open?
Well, I meant I was...
More lights.
Blast or heavy shield. Seal integrity maintained. Power status off. Okay. So she's learned... So this is going to be a bit of a tutorial thing, isn't it? Oh. It's telling me that I'm getting further away from the objective. Wait. No, it's not. Okay, so little waypoints. I turned on the waypoint so it'd be easier just to be able to get from point A to point B. That's something you can toggle off. What is this? Hololock. Electromagnetic security mechanism with standard holographic UI. Interface unavailable. I don't know which way to turn it, but I'm going to. Well, that did it. And the rest of these, can I interact with them? No.
The door changed color too.
Is it just me, or is she just in a weird stage of puberty? Like, her head is a little big for her body. She'll grow into it. Find a way out. Alright. That's not gonna help me. Ooh, there's a box over there. What's in the box? Nope. Down the stairs. And I'm already agreeing with the early game reviews that said this is going to be one of the most visually stunning games I've ever seen. Because this is definitely a looker.
It's got a device, like the one I found.
You think I want it this way? It's the best I can do. He's right behind you. Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Show me. Show me again.
I can do. He's right behind you. Hi! Happy birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man. Look, Daddy can't be there with you and Mom, but we can still have a party, right? Sure we can.
Birthday, Isaac. Daddy sure does love his little big man.
Oh no. Are we gonna be carrying on really bleak and dark undertones about what's happened to the past? Cause that is setting a tone immediately. Of happiness dead. I mean, you know what I mean, right? You know what I'm trying to say? I can't get over there. That kind of the death of an innocent message and an innocent thing happening, and it's all just gone to hell. You know what I'm talking about? Hoping you do. All right, I want this.
Well, happy new year, dear diary. Can you believe we actually celebrated last night? Well, we did. Kind of. Director Evans invited everyone to gather in the community room. Don't know where she got the party hats. That was a ghoulish touch. So there we sit, watching the clock tick down to midnight, and I'm thinking, am I the only one who gets the symbolism of this? It might have been worth it if Skylar had gotten drunk again, but I seem to be in a state he doesn't want to repeat.
I feel like almost Dead Space audio logs.
I saw them lining up in the community room. Like cattle in a slaughterhouse, but smiling at each other. Jonah handing out meds, like being alive is some kind of pain to be eased. Well, not me. I don't want to go quiet. I don't want to trail off. I want a period at the end of my life sentence, not an ellipsis. Hell, an exclamation mark. So if that upsets whoever finds this, too bad. I don't know anyone, anything, anymore.
Oh god, he shot himself to make a statement. So they were purposefully committing suicide. So something was coming. And they knew it. That impending doom can do some. Oh god, I forgot to hit the thing. Ah, camera. At least I know it's been about 30 minutes since I turned this thing on. Okay, and forgot to make it where the shutter wouldn't close after 30 minutes.
Why did they die here? What happened to them?
Seems like a choice.
I mean, seriously? Record our thoughts for posterity? Great idea, Director Evans. Like, I haven't done enough for posterity already. Like, I wouldn't be here like this if not for posterity. I'm done with posterity. Posterity can go.
They all died willingly here, and then ended their lives when they knew they couldn't do any more. So what is it they're trying to do? These data corruption severe. Noticing that there's different levels of data corruption on these things. Oh, did I not hit to actually play it back?
And maybe that's all I need, you know. That moment the door opened and you were standing there wearing that retro weak dress. And the way you smiled, I had to look away. Are you gonna see on my face what had just blossomed inside me, you know? It was just an instant, but I knew. I knew we'd be forever.
And Machu Picchu. Always wanted to see that. I never did. Why didn't I go with Owen when he asked? Stupid. Um, what?
It's weird, in this holographic state, I can see who they are a little better. Did I see Jackson Fryer? Fry, not...
Pray for us sinners, now, and at the hour of our death. I mean, death. I'm sorry. It's been a while. And, well, these meds Johnny gave us are really something. So, okay, from the top, kids. Hail Mary, full of grace.
You know, it's weird to think that even things like that were lost. If there were no record and all those things...
Aloy! Aloy! Are you down there? He found me! Ross found me! Aloy! Down here!
Oh, Mother be praised. Come, girl. Take my hand. You don't belong down there. Come! Such places are forbidden, Aloy.
I fell in.
They are of the metal world. What is that on your face?
Nothing.
Did you find it down there?
No.
Give it to me.
No.
Aloy, such things are dangerous.
No!
From home, you'll need to know how to survive in the wild. Come, Aloy. Home now. But starting tomorrow, you will learn to hunt.
To that plaything. We descend to the valley now. Follow. The wilds can be dangerous, Aloy. You will need to stay close and do as I say.
I know.
Now, you're still scratched up from that fall you took yesterday. So let's start there. Take this medicine pouch. I'll show you how to fill it. See this plant over here? It's called salvebrush. Come, gather its berries in your pouch.
Okay.
Good. Now eat the berries.
Okay. To transfer from medicine pouch to health. Oh.
They may taste bitter, but they can save your life. Always keep your pouch full of medicinal berries, flowers, and plants.
Where are we?
This valley is just a part of All Mother's embrace.
Embrace.
The Nora tribe watches these lands and keeps out the most dangerous machines. Usually.
Okay. I can already tell that my face is going in the top right. There's too many things over here on the top left that need to be seen.
Further down river, we'll find a herd of machines, and I will teach you how to hunt.
Are they dangerous?
All machines are dangerous, Aloy. Their power must be respected. But I will be beside you.
I bet he was outcast. He's self-imposed outcast because of whatever happened to his daughter, which is why he was okay with taking on Aloy.
Aloy, a machine's coming. Crouch and follow me into the tall grass.
Ooh.
There. Now stay low.
Little one.
No, Aloy. Such machines are called watchers. You must learn to avoid their gaze. If you are to survive in the wilds, I will show you. Listen close and do as I do. Stay still. Wait for it to pass. Now keep low and follow me across the trail to that tall grass.
How do they reconstruct and multiply? This is an interesting mechanic. I mean,
come back this way.
This actually speaks to the hunter in me.
The slower you move, the quieter you'll be. And crouched walking is quieter than upright.
This feels more natural to an actual hunter. When you have to stalk hunt on foot with the bow, you have to get close. You have to pay attention to the wind direction, the sounds you make, things you're brushing up against are putting your scent on it.
That's the last of them. Let's move on.
You have to be careful with that too. And usually, I mean, with a bow, like he's got, it looks like he's got a compound somehow. With a recurve, usually you can get away.
They didn't see or hear you. Now stay close. That herd should be just ahead.
It looks like he's got football pieces of like football padding plastic on him for protection. But like with a bow like his, you could probably get up to 75 yards easily, but 35, 25 if you're talking about like a just a recurve.
Who's that?
Ignore him.
But why is he up there? Smiling at us.
Teb! Get back where you belong! Teb! Where are you?
Ignore him. We are outcasts and he is of the tribe.
Maybe he doesn't like the tribe.
And he is a fool. Come now, let's find that herd. Follow.
He keeps the rituals and he says then he is a fool. Something happened with his daughter that made him turn his back on purpose. But since he kept rituals, that's why they entrusted the girl with him. He is an outcast and he could be relied on.
These are called striders.
When do I get my bow?
Ha! Get!
Why'd you chase them off?
To show you how some machines startle easily if they detect you and run away. They're best approached by stealth. Don't worry. We'll catch up with them further down the valley. You'll see.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Things I can grab.
Now, I want you to find some rocks that fit the cup of your hand.
Why?
Do as I say, Aloy, and gather the rocks. I will show you how to use them.
Distractions? I'm
gonna. Those will do. Follow.
Hold on. I'm picking stuff up. I'm assuming the rocks are distractions or a basic sling, but he gave me a bow, so I'm gonna go with distraction. Alright, so that green bar is how much I've got gathered in my medical pouch.
There's the herd. Alright, it's time to throw some rocks.
But rocks can't hurt machines, right?
No, but they can distract them, draw them into traps.
Yep.
Like that watcher over there. It must be dealt with, or it will warn the herd and send them running before we get in range.
Warn them? How?
The machines speak to each other, Aloy. Unless they are first silenced. Now you stay here on the ridge. On my signal, throw rocks and draw the watcher over to me. Wait for my signal.
How many six-year-olds do you remember doing stuff like this? Okay, but where did
Aloy, throw a rock near me.
Okay. Okay.
Throw a rock to draw the watcher towards me.
Ooh.
There. Come, girl, it's safe now.
Okay. Loot the carcass. I am going to pick up more shit. Because in games like this, I never know what the crafting system is going to be, and they mentioned something of crafting things on the fly, even in the midst of battle once you get used to it. So
harvest the kill so I can teach you how to make arrows.
Okay, and take all.
Use the stalks as arrow shafts and metal shards for arrowheads.
All right, L1 weapon wheel. Press and hold X to quick craft hunter arrows. So this is how you got a quick craft in the middle of a battle. Doing this right here to make more supplies. Okay.
Good. You'll never run out of arrows if you know how to craft what you need. Let's put those arrows to use. Follow.
Ooh. Seriously though, what kind of bow do I got? Does that have cams on it? I'm like interested in this bow. No, it's just a recurve.
Here, stay low in the grass and be quiet. It's time to make your first kill. Strider, one of the weaker machines. But even a weak machine can kill a hunter if she's careless. You must study your prey. Its hide is thick, but there are spots where it is vulnerable, like its eye. Can you guess another?
Yeah, with this technology I got on my head. R2. Weakness. Body. Body. Okay. What's that? Blaze canister weakness.
A canister on its back. Is that a weakness?
Yes. How did you guess that?
The device. It showed me.
Ooh.
But that plaything? Stop playing games. Now, take down that strider. Target the eye or the canister. And if it charges, be ready to roll out of the way.
Roll out. To loose the arrow. Yes, that is how you say it. To loose the arrow.
Hit! Keep firing! Hit! Keep firing!
I did. I got it. Ooh, what do I get? Take it all,
you
yes.
You did well today, but you have much to learn. Tomorrow, we train again. What was that?
That boy. The one running the brave trails.
Follow Aloy. Quick.
I'm quickly following, but first I'm going to grab this. So if I shoot the canisters off the back, I get something. It's not a play toy if I was able to correctly guess a weak point. Rost, you should know that immediately. But I'm assuming there's a stigma against using any of the old technology.
Ah!
he's alive. He's lucky for that. Rolling friction. Best kind of friction out there.
Do nothing. It's only a matter of time before the machines find that boy and kick him to death. But if I shoot, it will cause a stampede and it will trample him.
But I can see the paths they take.
Stop telling stories.
I'm not. I can sneak through.
You will not.
Where's the boy? So I know it's gonna take this path. Oh, that's some cool info. Okay, lots of crouching. I want these though. I would like to take this, please. I would like this.
We need to move slowly, quietly, so I can sneak past them.
Okay. So, what am I going for next? I'm trying to get over there. So you. Oh, you only come so far. So I'm just jumping from cover to cover right now. So what she got interacts with old technology. That's a duh, but what did she get?
Got to be careful.
Okay. Okay, so is water going to make more sound? Okay. No, I gotta be worried about these guys.
I need to see their paths.
Ooh, how are they tracking with that eye? Okay. Hold on. Uh-oh.
Almost there.
Okay. So, if I get out of that mode, I will still be sneaking and be able to see the tracks. And it's got... Yeah, it has a set path. It's a machine, and I guess it goes into a pre-programmed set path once it's where it's supposed to be.
There he is.
Hey there, dude. Hey, Teb.
Hey.
What? How is this?
Okay, where safety's over there. reveal your secrets quite yet. I don't know if I can trust this boy. I get the feeling I can. Oh, that's trippy. That's cool. That is unique. I mean, it's not 100% unique, but it's kind of like people's personalities. And this is just coming straight from kind of like the gist of my education kind of being distilled down into a few words of wisdom, that no one person's traits are unique. It's the fact that you take all those bland, ununique, thousands and thousands of other people have traits, and you take each one of those traits and put it into one specific person, and you get a very unique individual. This is kind of what this game is. Nothing here seems to be unique yet, but it's unique in that all of it's happening in one time in this game, in a setting that's not been explored quite yet.
Wait. Oh, Mother, bless that girl. Bless you both.
Boy!
She saved me. I just wanted...
Boy! Seal your lips. They are outcasts, both. And she is motherless.
They're assholes.
Come now. Back to Mother's heart.
That boy should not have spoken to us. It's against tribal law. We'll go home now. Follow.
I get the feeling she rejects.
The way.
Yeah, she's not too happy about that, especially being I wouldn't quite. Flashpoints offer moments of emotional choice. How, I almost said it. Aloy expresses her personality is up to you. Choose the fist and Aloy to confront the challenge directly. Choose your brain and use her insight. Use the heart. Okay. Oh, God. Oh, I like this. Yes, another not unique thing in a unique setting. This is what I was trying to say. Just look at any one person and kind of break down the traits, and you'll be like, okay, but each little individual thing that they might pride themselves on, you know that there are tons of other people that have that little minute detail of the personality. But then you look at a person as a whole and you're like, but they're the only person that has all of those mundane, ordinary, bland, and very much out there traits. And they're all in one person, and all of a sudden you have a person and a personality. And instead of having a statistic of what's the norm and what's the average and what's this, that, and the other, you have a human being that doesn't fit into that statistic because they are a combination of boring, plain, mundane, ordinary things that have only ever been in that combination, really, in one person. So I love it when a game kind of takes things that have already been done, but is like, we've never quite seen it like this. And we've seen like choices and moral choices and how you express people. And I've seen it. Like Life is Strange is one of the ones games I've played that, you know, you get to make choices on how the character develops and how much of an asshole you might be. Or with The Walking Dead, with Clementine's personality, she can be sassy and an asshole, or she can be sweet and kind and caring. I'm not going to go for aim for his head, but I'm not going to drop the rock. I'm going to knock it from his hands. I think I'm going to go with the brain side of things.
Hey! for picking berries.
Yeah, she's still a kid.
You're bleeding. Let me have a look. Here, hold still. I'll get it.
Why? Why am I an outcast?
Aloy, this is not the time.
Who was my mother?
Aloy, I've told you before, that's not for us to know. You were just a newborn when the Matriarchs brought you to me.
So the Matriarchs, they know?
It's not so simple.
But they know.
Aloy, we are outcasts.
So how do I make them tell me?
The Matriarchs? There is a way, perhaps.
So tell me.
It would be dangerous.
How?
It would take years of training.
I don't care. How do I do it? Tell me.
The proving. The tribe's rite of passage held every year. Those who pass become braves. But to the one who wins, the Matriarchs grant a boon.
A boon?
Yes, whatever the winner wants.
Then I'll do it. Whatever it takes, I'll win the proving.
I see. We'd best get started then. Your training will be hard, and it'll take years.
Start training? Yes. Follow.
I like this girl. Rocky training montage.
Rost? Rost? Rost?
Where is he? 2 days before the proving and he goes off without me? He wouldn't do that.
All right. So, I approve so far. It's definitely different. We're gonna check out unlocking skills and everything in the next video, but this is definitely worth the time and effort to put into it to learn exactly the story they're trying to tell already. Even even I'm gonna try to ignore other reviewers because many times they're wrong. You many times can get your opinion heard if it has a twinge of falseness to it. If there, if you can tell when you read something that there is just a twinge of something that is off, you will usually get called out on it. And being called out when you're doing a review is actually a really good way to get publicized and re-promoted without you having to do anything. If you write it, like if I were to write a great review on like one of the greatest works of all time, and then I just put a blatant lie in the middle of it, being like, character progression was awful, or development was awful, but you know, other than that awful oversight by the writer, this game or this book or this TV show, this movie, and I did that, people would read the review because it's a review. They would see that, and then they would make a critique about it and point out, you know, well, Darkness said that this is happening, but in my opinion, blah, blah, blah. And you go and read that article, and they're like, what are you talking about? And they go back to yours, and somebody else points it out, and you get references back to what you're saying. So many times reviewers will purposefully try to be overpraising or too critical so that other people can critique it. See what I mean? So, I know that there's something I was going to say more about this, about what I read in one of the very early on reviews, and then one of the ones from just a week ago of just kind of a synopsis of what people thought about it. I'm going to try to actually just not say anything anymore about those reviews and just take it as it is. So, thank you so much for watching. I hope you're enjoying it. Let me know in the comments what you think so far about it. It's telling a story. It's got a story to tell. It's visually stunning. The controls and everything, like I said, it just kind of, it feels like games have already done it, but they've never done it this way. I mean, it's never been quite this combination as they're presenting it so far. So you can borrow a lot of assets and still make something incredibly unique, just like every single human being is. That's the whole point I was trying to make. You can not have a single original thing inside of something, but if it's an original combination of those things, then you have something unique. So I'm excited to see what this game brings. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you thought in the comments. Give a thumbs up if you want to see this continued on. I'm going to sign off for right now. I hope you enjoyed yourself. Stick around for the next one. I promise it'll be up as fast as I can get it. And I hope to see you back here for it really, really soon. Bye!